Hello and welcome to this tutorial. Today we're going to walk you through the integration of 2N IP intercoms with Milestone XProtect VMS 2019. You'll need the enhanced video license, and you'll also need the enhanced integration license if you wish to take advantage of the automation functions. For more information, check our webpage or contact the 2N integration team. In this scenario, we have multiple cameras from our IP intercoms added to Milestone XProtect. People can enter the building using their credentials. The information is forwarded to Milestone using our 2N plugin for Milestone XProtect Access. Visitors without credentials can communicate with XProtect Smart Client via ONVIF if necessary. The operator can instruct the visitor or grant access remotely. Now let's see how all parts of this integration are configured. To connect the intercom with the recording server of Milestone XProtect, we need to activate the video stream, which is disabled by default, and create an ONVIF account in administrator mode. Now we can enroll the intercom in the Milestone XProtect management client. Knowing the IP address, we can select the manual mode. You can specify the login created when activating the ONVIF account in the previous step. Make sure you have ONVIF selected. Now you specify the IP address of the intercom and click Next. The intercom is enrolled. We want all the available hardware that we can organize into folders. Now we have another camera connected to our recording server. We can open the XProtect Smart Client and place the camera into our scenario. In order to integrate 2N access control with Milestone XProtect, you need to download and install the plugin. You'll find it on the product page of 2N Access Commander. You'll also need to have 2N Access Commander software installed and set up, with all the 2N devices enrolled and placed into zones. If you're not familiar with this product, you'll find more information on wiki.2n.cz. After installing the plugin, it's recommended to restart the management server. Now we can create an access control and connect it with 2N Access Commander. We need to specify the IP address of the 2N Access Commander server and the administrator login to the system. It will automatically detect all connected devices that are represented as doors in Milestone XProtect. In the next step, we can assign a camera to each door. It can be the camera of the intercom or any other camera enrolled in Milestone XProtect. Now let's go ahead and place the access monitor. We select the door that we want to monitor in this tile and the related camera. We also want to have the option to activate the door remotely. We can use the overlay button for this. We'll use the button related to output 1 of the intercom. Let's change the description and adjust it a little. Now we need to specify what happens upon activation of this output. For that, we'll use a very simple automation function. We'll take the block ONVIF virtual output changed, it will be triggered automatically anytime the button in Milestone is pressed. We need to select port 50 for output 1 in Milestone. Note that the inputs may index differently depending on the device. With this event, we will activate switch 1, which will open the door. You can trigger other actions and outputs based on this event. To complete our scenario, we need to configure an action based on an event from the intercom. In order to achieve that, we have added this simple automation which sends a signal to Milestone XProtect via virtual ONVIF input anytime a button is pressed. We can see that when pressing the button, the input is really activated. In Milestone, the activated input has number 1, although in the automation function we used port number 0. Again, this is because the ports in the intercom may be indexed differently. Please note that we will only see it if input rising and input falling events are configured for this input. For our demonstration, we'll send a video stream to a matrix window upon the input activation. First, we need to create the matrix. We specify the IP of the client we run the smart client on and a password of our choice. Then we place the matrix window to our scenario and connect the matrix we have just created by entering the previously created password. Now we can set up the rule. We add a new rule that will set the matrix to view an external camera. We'll also add the stop function to change the view to default after 10 seconds. Finally, we get a pop-up video anytime someone presses the button to start a call from the intercom. With this, our scenario is complete. Thank you for watching the tutorial. If you need more assistance, please contact our integration team or visit our webpage.